So far nobody is here today. It's around lunchtime, gonna go for afternoon hunt. So just show you what I put on GC, my dog. My dog's name's GC. So I put a rip collar on it, and then I put the GPS, which I'll turn it on now. And then the handheld GPS for me. And then what I've started doing now is I've started putting a shock collar on him. So I'll just turn all the devices on. Now when he gets out too far, I send him a beep like this, and that means for him to return back to me. So sometimes he can go 350 meters out, or sometimes he goes a little bit too close to the farmland, and then I just send him a message saying come back, and just come back to me, which he normally does. If he jumps onto somebody's farm and start chasing livestock, I normally give him a vibration, and then followed by the shock, which he'll know not to do. So that's the setup that I've got, and it seems to work for me. That's what he looks like when he's all set up. For today, I'll be bringing in my rifle. GC is now 9 months old. He chases anything that moves around in the bush. We're just heading down this little track here, which someone's made, I guess, and we're heading towards a clearing to see if there's any fresh new signs. Then we'll go from there. Someone's been shooting some goats, which has kind of attracted some pigs into this area. As you can see, like old pig rooting. It's looking good. It's looking good as in there's pigs around. So these are probably a week old. Probably during lockdown. Probably during lockdown when they came out. Come on, boy. Come on, boy. If I do see a goat, I'm just gonna shoot it, take the meat, and then just leave the carcass around these areas, just so that they just keep coming in and out. It's definitely a pig. Can't be anything else. Dog's out just having a sniff around. That there caught my attention. It was actually that hole. I was looking at that hole from 100 meters out, and I was thinking, that looks weird. Then discovered that. Good boy. Good boy, good boy. Good boy. Good boy. Find it. Working overtime now. Okay, got the location. Just need some more dogs. Just gonna go back and then check out some more routing spots. We'll just go around there and hopefully the wind's blowing the right way, and just hoping that there'll be some pigs around there that he can get a sniff of. That's the plan. That's another great sign. They're in the area. We just don't know how far they travel from their rooting spots. There's no doubt about it that I'm in the right spot. Just for you guys, when I come to a spot, I don't talk. I make sure nothing's here first and then I start talking. So definitely in the right spot, but man, this pig hunting business is hard work. They're not as easy as goats or any other animal. Pig and deer, challenging to hunt. It's just only a couple hours before dark, so I'm gonna head back to the car. Got a couple hours of walking to get back to the car anyway. That's the thing that blows my mind, is that you see signs and some are fresh, some aren't. And you're just thinking, where did they go? Where are they? Where should I go? I just need to get this dog within range, and he'll search it out. If we can find a possum, find any other thing around, I'm sure we can find a pig. Come on, let's go. So I try not to hunt near any farmland because of the livestock that's around. Where am I going? Straight ahead, I guess. Okay folks, it's not quite a deer or a pig, but we've had a good walk around and, you know, I guess I'd rather have a goat rather than having nothing. So I'll take that one home and probably get a friend to cook up a curry for me. Leave it. So the reality is, if I was to walk in a bush like this all by myself, any animal can hear me coming and I wouldn't be able to get a shot in. So just having a dog just to find it and hold it. I know that it's just a goat, but I'm pretty sure you can do it to anything now. So that's my hunting dog in a nutshell at this stage. That's what he does. And I'm happy with that. I mean, I know that, I didn't know this before, but I didn't know there was like a code for pig hunters, like you shouldn't be using a gun and this, but oh, whatever, you know, it's just as long as I can come into the bush and get meat, that's the ideal. That's what hunting is all about. Got the leg and back strap, most of the meat is there. It's just about an hour before it gets dark. 500 more meters to the road. Boy, I'm getting tired. All right, suck it in. Just went uphill for 100 meters. Thankfully it's flat. Hopefully it's not too rough. Sun's starting to come down. Just got 300 meters to go. Just spotted some pig rooting 300 meters from the road. They're quite old, but that shows that there are pigs around. Oi, catch a pig next time. Oh, that is a good sign. That is a good sign. All right, we arrived at our car. and as you can see, we've been going through the bush. Anyway, so that's what we're up to. If GC can get on to a couple of pigs, he'll be up and running, no doubt about it. And I mean, I would like him to get deer as well. I just want him to get anything in the bush, as long as it's meat that I can cook up.